All right, guys. So today we are going to talk about the topic that is procrastination. And I think you all, every people know about the procrastination. It's a kind of habit of delaying work. The work that you want to do, we are not doing at a specific time that has time given by any people or maybe the work that we are going to do. So I think it's not a good habit. And in long term, definitely it's going to affect you. It's okay in just a shorter term. We feel if we will delay 1 hour, 2 hours, but gradually it becomes a habit of us. And then definitely it's not a good for your work, for your job. And even if you are preparing for any competitive exam, and you can realize just because we have this tendency to delay our work, procrastinate, what happens? So we are not doing any work at a time. Just take a simple example of competitive exam. We also have some kind of tendency that I will complete my syllabus just after 2 days, after 1 week, but it's never gonna end. So we have to do it every single day. You know, if we want to achieve something, it's not going to happen in one. Take a simple example of this English language that we are learning nowadays. So if we want to improve, yesterday we have talked how to just get rid of some mistake, reduce mistake. So how it is possible? It is possible when we will add some little more minute work every single day, the practice part. So we think maybe one day, 1 week, or in last of the month, we will practice more than 24 hours. That's why it's okay to just inconsistent, or it's okay not to join just this half an hour session. But that is not going to help you. So instead of making procrastination, or instead of delaying the thing, add few minutes every single day, and that will be more helpful for you. And this is a skill, you know. Don't take it as, okay, if I'm not going to do anything, this is my tendency or mind. No, this is not your mindset, but it is a skill that you have to achieve doing work at a time. After that, we can do anything. So if we have mastered one time, it's going to help you in overall lifetime, in your work, in your job, and whatever you will do in future. And that will decide, you know, at what extent you can get your success, the work that you are doing at a time. Okay, so this is from my side. Now, Hiren.
Okay. Yeah, procrastination is the thing that we often keep doing repeatedly. And, you know, but first of all, I would like to say that we need to become a doer instead of being, say, a speaker. You know, just because, you know, there's so much difference between doing and saying. We keep saying all the time that I'll do this, I'll do that, you know, blah blah, instead of, you know, doing that thing. We don't wanna work, and you know, we need to overcome the habit of delaying any task, no matter whether it's a small or a big, and try to be, you know, always try to become, you know, positive instead of becoming negative. And you know, punctual also, we should be punctual towards our work, and we should not, you know, leave our work in pending. In fact, you know, we should complete as early as we can, and what we can do, we should adopt, you know, some anti-procrastination strategy, and that's how we can, you know, overcome the procrastination. And we should make our mind that we have to complete this work, any task, no matter, somehow, at any cost. You know, sometimes we procrastinate because of, you know, laziness. Sometimes not only because of laziness, but because of we think that we have so much time, we'll do it later. So. And what happens at the end, we are punished or we are charged if we are any, you know, any specific place. So we should definitely try to, you know, overcome procrastination. Okay, that's all from my side.
Okay, Monty. Are you there, bro?
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
So, hello, guys. So I think today we have to talk about the what is the topic? Actually, it is very, it takes for me difficulty to speak that word. So I'm just saying about the topic. So actually I have tried many times, but I have some kind of what we say.
The topic is simple, that you know, we have tendency to delay our work. How to get rid of that, to delay our work? Lazy.
Yeah, so actually it is lazy. Laziness that is happening with, I think, maximum of the persons. So it's about the emotions, first of all, from my point of view, because I'm just giving my example, because many times what happens when I'm just doing any work, I'm just delaying that work. And it is basically that the controlling of emotion. I'm not able to control my emotions because I give the preferences of my mobile, as well as if I want to prepare for any competitive exam, then I should delaying that work. I just giving my maximum of the time in my mobile, as well as I go outside for playing games. And also at daytime, and I just go to friend's house for cracking some jokes. So just I waste my time, and I'm just saying that I will definitely do that work within 2 days. So it can't happen. If you're working for any competition exam, you're working for any physical exercises, or you're working for any, you can't do that work in the 1 day. Some of the specific works were there that were done in the 1 day, but basically if you are doing, if you want to do something higher, so you have to basically work hard. You have to control your emotions, as well you have to give it that time. And so you have to make a timetable, first of all, that in that day I have to do 2 to 3 works, and you have to give your specific time. So you have to do that works only. You don't have to do other works on that day. If you want to if you want to go to the gym, then first of all you have to give daily, you have to go give the time on the daily basis, because you can't become the, I think, a good gymer, good bodybuilder in the 1 day. So you have to be consistent in that work, because we can see that a commitment is very easy. If you are starting any work, that you require a commitment, but you want to finish any work, you should be consistent then. Yeah, that's all. Yeah,
exactly. All right. So now Kajol.
Yeah, it's about overcome, right? How to overcome procrastination, right?
Yeah.
So I think, you know, to avoid procrastination, or to avoid, you know, laziness in our work, think, you know, it is started, you know, when we are doing the small things. It is started from the small things. And, you know, to overcome from all those things, I think it is important to take action, you know, in very small level. Because if you start doing the things in a small level, it will automatically, you know, happen that we will not do in larger scale. So it always, I think, to overcome from all those things, we should start it from the small things. And if we do this, if we start the things from a small level, then it will automatically help us in longer level, or for, you know, for long term also. The more time most of the people think that if we start, you know, I just forgot a word, that's why I'm just confusing. Most of the people said that, you know, if we improve ourselves in larger level, then it will automatically, you know, improve in small level. But I think it is not right. If we start improving in basic level or small level, I think it will automatically help us in larger level also. So to overcome from to overcome from the laziness, I think it will be better for us to do the things in a small level, either doing anything, I think, either doing our personal thing, or for preparing for UPSC, or anything, for preparing for competitive exam, or for anything. Because if you started improving yourself in your personal level, it will automatically help you in career level also. So I think that's okay. What we can do. So if you want to keep some objects from some place to another, so just don't let the thing happen that I will do it later. Just do it right now. I think it will be better. If you start doing that thing in that level, I think it will also help you in all the level, I think. So that's my point.
All right. Shivam? Bro, Shivam, unmute yourself.
And hello. Yeah. Hello. Am I audible, bro?
Yeah, you are.
Yes, I will say to increase your efficiency, first of all, we should work in an organized manner. We should think that we should make our plan that what will we do in our whole day. And start working on that thing, and we can also take small breaks during if we are doing some work that will make us more efficient, and we should take a proper sleep because that will fresh our mind, and after that we can work with full efficiently. Fully efficient working we can done after that, and we can also make a timetable of a whole day before sleeping, that that when you are going to the bed, that we should decide that on next day what we will do. If you will talk about the studies, then we can fix our study plan, and we can also pick some entertainment time that I will enjoy in this time, and after that I will study again, and you can do whatever you want after that.
All right. Mm-hmm. Sure. Okay, this is all from your side. All right, Arshdeep, now you can speak. What do you think about it? Arshdeep, are you there? Okay, Sunil.
Now I'm audible?
Yeah, you are audible now.
Okay. First of all, how are you, everyone? All are, I hope all are fine. Today we are discussing about an organization's.
No, today we are discussing about how to overcome laziness. What do you think about
okay.
it?
How we can overcome laziness from our body?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, first of all, according to my opinion, I think we should eat healthy food and whenever we do work in a full day, at that time we should take rest for some time, then we cannot feel laziness. And the another thing is we should not always feel whenever we get free from anywhere, at that time we should not laying on bed and take to rest, because at that time we will automatically feel laziness. So we at that time we should do other work.
All right. Okay, this is all from your side. Okay, Sunil, everyone mute yourself and give your perspective about it.
So, Drew, what's the topic today?
The topic is we have to talk about how to overcome laziness.
Okay, so
yeah,
laziness for what?
For how to stop procrastinating. You know, we have tendency of procrastination, that we have tendency to delay our. And it happens in every single field. Like if you are doing a study, some also sometimes if you want to acquire new skill. It happens that time. Sometimes our parents tell us something to do, but we just procrastinate. So in that term, overall, you can talk about that. Yeah.
Okay. So I have not much idea, but to be my own experience, I would say that all the things we do in day or night, they are interconnected. So if we fix one thing, then other thing automatically will take place. So for example, if I make a schedule of awakening and in the morning, then I think automatically other thing will take place automatically. Like if I made a plan to wake up at 6 o'clock, and if I regularly follow that schedule, then I think other things like our whatever we are doing, study or professional or whatever I job, I think we will do better. So for example, some year ago, I was just made a decision to do exercise regular basis. So I just fixed this habit, and then a tremendous changes I saw in myself. So I think all are things interconnected. If we just fix one thing, then I think other thing will automatically change. So first of all, we should pick up one thing. Like if we have a bad habit of eating bad things, like we can take like fast food, or we not take proper diet, proper nutrition diet, well-balanced diet, then I think if we fix that habit, then I think other things automatically change. So that's thing I wanted to say. And for example, like students, so they can, make simply a plan that I will study this chapter, that chapter, or that thing for an hour without any interruption. And if they complete, then they automatically, feel satisfied, or they get kind of crushed. Then after, I think they can change another things. So that's the thing I wanted to say. Over to you.
Yeah, exactly, bro. It's a good point that you made. Everything is connected to each other. So even if we have a courage to get up early every single day, it is also something that can give you some more confidence, and also you can get rid of this kind of habit. Okay, all right. Great point that you made. Vinny? Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
So I am going to talk about today's topics. So there are different ways to avoid procrastination. Like making a schedule is a great way to manage your time. All the friends, teachers, and seniors recommended us this every time. By following timetable, we see a great difference in our daily routine. We have more extra time than usual, and then we utilize that time in extra activities. In this way, we become a more productive, and do our work in a very less time. Second thing is that we commit to yourself and your work. Don't leave today's work to tomorrow. Like many students say that we have more time, leave that work to, we will do it tomorrow because we have enough time. So we shouldn't do this. We have to adopt the habit of doing the tasks and projects within the days. So it's better for our future.
Yeah. Okay, this is all, Vinny?
Yeah, this is all.
Okay, Nabil, now you can just wrap up this session or your comment.
Yeah, so firstly, if I talk about procrastination, so worst part of the procrastination is that it kills our motivation as well as our confidence if we constantly do the things in terms of procrastinate. So it definitely kills our confidence. So the point is that how can we overcome or how can we avoid the procrastination? So the thing is, firstly, you have to make a realistic goals. Means what is the realistic goals? Like suppose if you learn something, so firstly you have to make your goals in a smaller amount, not you have to go for large. If you go for large, so after 2 or 3 days later you feel it's fed up and you think it's really hard for me, you always beat yourself up, so it is not helpful for you. So the thing is, you have to work in a moderate in a initial time. And the second thing is, you have to track all the things. Like, you have to write. You should make a journal or diary, and you have to write your goals, write your tasks which you wanna complete. And if you are not able to accomplish that goal, so what you should do, you should punish yourself. I'm not saying that completely punish, but you have to rectify yourself. Like, if I am not able to do this work, so I, the next day I will do it in a second time, means I will do that work more than 2 times. So that is why your brain think that, oh, that you are very, what can I say, obsessed with this thing. So your mind, they never avoid that things to do. Your mind thinks that how can we perform that work in different kinds of tactics, they will apply in your mind. And the second thing is, if you accomplish your goal, so you should reward yourself. Like, suppose if I go to gym and I have to do workout, and fortunately I accomplish my goal, so what should I do? I should reward myself. I think that I feel that I should do something which I want. You can do whatever you want, whatever you like, you can do only for that, because you have accomplished that thing. That is the main thing. And the second thing is that you never think that you can achieve the things in a very short time. So you have to make our goals in a really realistic way. That is the things. And the things, last thing of procrastination, it is depends on our mind. Because, you know, when we do something new, so our brain always resists that things. Means, what is the means of resist? Like, if we learn English language, and if you are beginner, so initial time our mind, our brain don't accept that language. They think it is very hard, you can't learn it, you can't learn it. Means they completely resist the things. But what we happen if we do it constantly, so on that time our brain thinks differently. Means our brain thinks that how can we learn that things. They never resist that thing, but they think that what kind of tactics, what kinds of ways we can apply to learn that language. So that is the thing. So you have to be more courageous person, because you just stick yourself. If you stick 21 days, because if you Google it, so you can found that if you do any work constantly 21 days, you will be habitual of that work. So you have to be consistent. It is the main thing. Whether you can reduce the time, you can reduce the amount of the time or intensity, you can short the intensity or timing, but you have to do it at least one in a day. That is the way. Yes.